My ass is like Fred Flintstone. I can't figure this out, player.
I was watching you. I couldn't figure it out either, but I was watching you going through your method acting at the moment.
Yeah. I was like, yeah, I was going to tap dancing out here. I didn't know what's going on. How you been, Mike?
Awesome. Awesome. Awesome, brother.
You're looking great, man. I hear you're in Florida now, huh?
Yes, and it's baking out here.
Yeah, it's humid out there. You went from, like, the driest place in Vegas, where it's like an oven,
yeah, to now you're in. Yes, it's so humid out here. I don't know what to do out here, man.
Walking around marinating all day. So, Mike, man, I wanted to talk to you about what's been on your mind. I know you're very passionate about this Hulu story, correct?
Well, listen, that's not really my story. That's a story that some people or some past friends are producing, and it starts sometime next week or so, I think. But I have nothing to do with it. I had, they offered some of my friends, Dana White and other people, money to promote their show. Dana called me and I let him know I wasn't involved. They pretended like I was. And that's what they've been doing. Dana took, gave them the money back. He cut business with them. And just the fact, that's not how you do business. He was going to give Dana a couple of $1 million to promote the show and give me nothing to be in the show. I don't know how that man. Then don't forget Mario. And then they threw the black man card in there. We're going to have a movie to show the black man's existence and life. You know, some phony stuff. Some exploitation stuff. I'm the black man that needs to be helped, I guess. So I don't know. I have no idea, brother, what's going on. This is not how you have relationships. This place, Hulu's trying to. They make bad stories about people, and then I saw they don't make anything positive about anybody. That's their MO. Make it messy and nasty.
Well, Dana's a great guy. He happens to be a good friend of mine. That was a real class act, class move. That
oh man,
I saw that, which was great.
They tried the WBC with Mario Suleman. It didn't work. They gave them championship belts because they thought it was for me. And that's what they're doing. They're going around eliciting people with the idea that I'm involved.
So they never reached out to make an offer to try to get you involved, Mike?
Never at once.
Wow. Wow. So, because there's a lot of rumors out there about different projects. I know at one point Jamie Foxx was going to play you, right?
It's a whole total monster, different monster than Jamie and them.
God, it's a whole nother deal.
Yeah, okay. These quack. Wannabe producers just want to be very evil. There's nothing going to be positive in their shows. Their shows are all about, I don't know, yucky television, fake TV, like Donald Trump said. It's all fake stuff. They got be probably most of it be yes from the headlines or stuff that I wrote, but they have no real significance and stuff, not that I know of.
Yeah, and are they still planning on going forward with it?
I believe so. Yes.
Wow, so you're getting the word out. Just
look like me. If you see him jump rope and train, man, you think the guy had two amateur fights.
Yeah, we ain't got that peekaboo style going right there then, huh?
You don't have no concept of it.
No concept. So, Mike, I know that you've been working on your own story, too. When can we look forward on that coming out? And you got any updates on that for us?
Well, as soon as that fake news stuff is over, then you have the real exclusive story from my mouth.
That's great, man. That's great. So so how many projects do you got right now going on telling your story?
Well, listen, I only have my product that I know of. I don't know how many different projects are out there. I have no say in that, but I'm going to have one, my personal project come out shortly, and it's just going to be the real things. It'll be coming out of my mouth.
Oh, that's awesome. Is that going to be a documentary, Mike, or more of like a scripted show, like a movie that we could see?
They're doing. Mine is a documentary, like a movie.
Oh, you're a documentary. Okay.
You know, it's going to really be a movie. I think we're going to do our own movies, perhaps. And that's how it's going to be, all inside jobs.
Yeah. And do you have like a time frame of when we can look forward to that?
Well, no, but I want to say something else before we go to another subject. I just want to thank all my friends. Dana, definitely, Jose Suleman, and everyone else that denounced these people as phonies, and plus my fans. My fans have been on my side 100%, and thank you too also, Mario.
Of course, you know you're my guy.
Thanks. Ditto.
Of course, of course. So, okay, congratulations on the project that you're involved in. Looking forward to checking that out. Mike, how's the cannabis business been treating you?
Oh, that's really awesome. Listen, only thing I can say is great things about it. I'm in 18, 20 states. I'm in more states, I think. I'm distributing more than anybody. Going into Canada, going into Europe.
That's awesome.
God, man, I'm the ganja god.
The ganja god. That's fantastic. And is Florida where you're spending most of your time, or are you going back and forth to Vegas now?
Well, Florida's where I live for a couple of years, and periodically I go back to Vegas, New York.
Okay, okay. And Mike, I can't go without talking a little quick boxing. What do you like in the Joshua Usyk fight?
Be for a couple of years. Am I now? I'm going to be here for a couple of years.
You're going to be here for a couple of years. Okay. Perfect. All right. I'm going to have to go visit you out there then. We'll see what's up. Thanks. Hey, what do you think about the Joshua Usyk rematch?
It's going to be hard to beat him. It's going to be hard to beat Usyk because he's sassy and he outpunched his jab. Joshua has to learn how to get away from his jab. That's the only thing that he couldn't handle. He couldn't handle his jab and his movement. He was too fast for Joshua. Joshua had to put a lot of pressure on him and keep it on him all night. He has to be more the powerful puncher, but he's not as active. You got to be active against a guy like that. He moves too much. The jab is educated and just outsmart the guy.
You got to be busy with that right there. And then I know this fight isn't set yet, but if it were to come to fruition, who do you like with Crawford versus Spence?
Hell of a fight.
Hell of a fight, huh?
Yeah, you got to listen. You got a master in there with a mean hell of a motherfucker, right?
Yeah.
And I would go, but the master is coming up in weight. He's a small guy, but he's been successful with big guys.
And right.
I used to look at the fight that Terrence had with the gentleman said, Porter, and I looked at the fight that he had with Porter. He handled Porter so easily when it was up and down fight with Spence. But then again, styles make fights.
Exactly.
The last fight Spence had with the Cuban, god damn. He got up, he got dropped, got up. The guy's a hell of a fighter too. Got up and killed him. You can't stand still with Spence. You gotta move.
Yep. Southpaw too.
Yeah, he has to do a lot of movement. He has to do a lot of movement. Because if you stand still, he'll break you down. You can't let him get on you. I'm Spence.
Last fight question for you, Mike. I know another fight that hasn't gotten made, but a lot of people are talking about it. What'd you think about like a potential Ryan Garcia Tank Davis fight?
I like Ryan Garcia against Haney.
Okay.
I think that would be an awesome fight. And I think those two guys will break some records because Garcia, he has a fanfare that's just big. He has a big fan following. And just because of that, that's why the fights with him will be bigger because it's his fan base.
Right. Right. Okay, I love that you keep up with the sport, Mike. And then I saw you at the UFC not so long ago, too. That's a trip, huh? We sat together before the one in down here in, what was it? No, not Long Beach, Anaheim. But it's a totally different kind of wild animal, huh?
Incredible. I didn't think Nunez could fight that well. I always looked at her as a brute. She's so smart. She's just a smart fighter, but she's some fighter, huh?
Heck of a fighter, man. Those ladies really go at it, man.
That other girl choked out. She dropped her three times.
I know. She was tough, though.
Dropping her all night. Smart boxing move. I thought that was Ray Lennon in there for a minute.
Exactly. Bloody and everything. She was
doing a move. I felt, oh.
Those 5-minute rounds were wild, man. Those were wild.
Man.
Well, listen, man, I'm really appreciative of your time. I'm glad we caught up. We got everybody straightened out. They know about the movies coming out, the one that we look forward to with you involved to it. I'm glad we got some boxing takes in there, my friend. And I look forward to having you on my show, Access Hollywood.
I'm looking forward, brother. Thank you for everything. You've been great, brother. Very kind.
All love. You know I got nothing but love. Hey. Take care. Have a good day. Hi to Kiki.
Hi, Mario.
Hi, Kiki. She's the best. That's the real champ. Take care, guys.
Bye. Elie Sekbak, reporting.
For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Sekbak, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Sekbak, reporting.